you want me, and I'll be yours completely, for better or for worse. I know we'll have our disagreements, be fighting for no reason. I wouldn't change it for the world. 'Cause I knew the first day that I met you, I was never gonna let you slip away. And I still remember feeling nervous, trying to find the words to get you here today.
2 summers ago, Jack came to me and he said he wanted to talk to me about something. And I could tell it was serious because he wasn't his usual jokey self. He was actually seemed kind of nervous. And as I listened, I heard him tell me how he wanted to ask Steph out on a date. He wondered what his dad and I would think about that. I said, well, we simply thought it was great. Steph, you are getting one of the 3 best things that I have done in my life. So please love him, honor him, and be his best friend. Don't be afraid to lean on him because he is strong, thoughtful, and he loves you with his great, big, happy heart.
When I sat down earlier this week to write my speech, I had no idea where to start. So I did the most logical thing I could think of and Googled how to write a good maid of honor speech. So here it goes. Google said to tell a couple stories about the bride. However, it said to avoid stories about drunken, embarrassing nights. So I don't actually have any good stories. When Stephanie called me up one day to let me know Jack had sent her flowers and wanted to take her on a date, I was like, who the F is Jack? She got all quiet and said, Jack Steinsky. And I was like, Jack Steinsky? Like our little brother's friend, Jack Steinsky? She then got extremely quiet and said, I encouraged her to ignore the age difference and go on the date, and I guess you can say the rest is history.
I do have a quote that I came across that seems so fitting. Happy marriages begin when we marry the ones we love, and they blossom when we love the ones we marry.
Life is easy to be scared of. With you I am prepared for what is yet to come.
Hi Jack, thank you Stephanie.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
My constant friend.
My constant friend.
My partner in life.
My partner in life.
My true love.
My true love.
To love you without reservation.
To love you without reservation.
To honor and respect you.
To honor and respect you.
To protect you from harm.
To protect you from harm.
To comfort you in times of distress.
To comfort you in times of distress.
To grow with you in love and spirit.
To grow with you in love and spirit.
I, Stephanie, take you, Jack.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
My constant friend.
My constant friend.
My partner in life.
My partner in life.
My true love.
My true love.
To honor you without reservation.
To honor you without reservation.
To protect you from harm.
To protect you from harm.
To comfort you in times of distress.
To comfort you in times of distress.
To grow with you in love and spirit.
To grow with you in love and spirit.
Excellent. We all rejoice as I pronounce you to be husband and wife, committed partners and friends from this day forward and forevermore.
Miss Bobby.
Oh, there you are. See the bride. Bride.
Bobby, you look lovely.
Hey, beautiful, beautiful.
Thank you.
Okay.
Taking out an avid this Chevrolet. There's a ring in the window just down the street. I wanna marry her, she wants to marry me. Money's kinda tight, but love don't care. Me and this truck been everywhere. Just need a little spot on the back page. Here's what I wanted to say. This truck will get the prettiest girl in town. Got a pretty good radio. If you wanna get her dancing down in Old Dirt Road, spend a lot of Friday nights up under the stars. Get you where you need to go and it'll go too far. God knows all the stories it could tell.
Even a boy 7 years younger could recognize. She had a need to feel Jacko's thunder. Jack, I can't sing this. Rob's right there. Are you sure? She had a need to feel Jacko's thunder. Somewhere deep between her thighs. To watch a storm and all its wonders raging in a young man's eyes. She had to ride the heat of passion like a comet burning bright, rushing headlong in the wind out where only dreams have been, burning both ends of the night. He labeled it Jacko's best summer ever. What a sweet guy.
To our families, thank you for being the most loyal and supportive groups of people. We are so lucky to have you all and appreciate you more than you'll ever know. Thank you to our moms and dads for teaching us what true love is and for making today happen. Mom, Dad, I'd like to extend a special shout out to you for always teaching me to respect my elders. This is why Steph and I work so great together.
To my bridesmaids, thank you for standing beside me today and for all the years leading today to today. You are all such amazing people, and I can confidently say I would not be the woman I am today without each and every one of you. I always said I'd never have bridesmaids, but when it came down to it, I couldn't have imagined today without all of you. If anyone needs a solid maid of honor, I highly recommend SJ. She's not the most organized person in the human on the planet, but she gets the job done, and it's a guaranteed good time if she's got anything to do with the planning the party.
J-Man-799. I couldn't have asked for better best man. You have been beside me since day one, from teaching me how to slide through the gears like a magician, to coming and sitting with me in the waiting room at the hospital after getting mistaken for a grizzly bear downtown Peterborough.
We were there.
You're the best friend a guy could ever ask for. Thank you for all that you have done and have supported me through. Trevor and Thomas, thank you for being the most amazing MCs. You took the role and absolutely ran with it. We couldn't appreciate you guys more. Thank you all. Thank you all for coming. Let's get after it. Amen.
Sun shines, clouds rain, train whistles blow and guitars play, preachers preach.
I can only think back to when Jack and Daryl used to play lacrosse together. And this one particular night, we are standing in the lobby, and I was with Stephanie, and she says, "Aw, look at that." Stephanie's always one to help out the underdog. She saw this poor kid over on the far side having trouble tying his shoes. So Stephanie walked over, and guess who it was? It was Jack. I'm just kidding. I know you wear Velcro.
I don't know if you guys are all aware or not, but Jack may have the worst case of sleep apnea this side of Ontario.
Sleep apnea. I know exactly what you're talking about. He presently sleeps across the hall from my bedroom. He forgot his mask the other night. I thought CN had moved into the house.
So the one night I made the mistake, Jack was in bed before I was, and I come up to the room, and so I'm laying there trying to fall asleep, and I'm thinking to myself, how is Jack ever gonna get a girlfriend the way he sleeps? And luckily enough for Jack, probably about 6 months down the road, Steph came into his life, and Steph, I can't begin to give you enough credit, because six nights beside this guy was more than enough for me. I can't imagine a lifetime of this freight train snoring next to me. So cheers to you, Steph. It's so easy loving you.
Fire burns, waves crash, seeds grow. It just comes natural.